Good morning, students. Welcome to General Science class. Did you enjoy your weekend? Are you ready to learn? Let me ask you, did you read the lesson properly? You have to read the lesson every day, okay? Read the textbook every day. In the previous week, we learned about acid and bases. Acids and bases. Both are chemicals, isn't it? Acids and bases both are chemicals, and in fact bases are the chemical opposite of acid. Okay, the chemical opposites of acid. When this acid and bases combine, they cancel out each other's effect. Okay, that also we have learned. And today let's learn about salt. Today let's learn about salt. Okay, and how do an acid and a base cancel out each other's effect? They react to form substances that are neither acidic nor basic. Okay, one of the new substances formed in this chemical change is called a salt. The other substance formed is water. So the substances formed when an acid and a base react, that are salt and water. Okay, so acid plus base, the substance formed are salt plus water. Okay, then the common salt we use to add flavor to the food is just one example of salt. Okay, it can be formed by mixing an acid and a base together, but the salt we get is not usually formed like that. Okay, it is we get by evaporating seawater. It is made by evaporating seawater. We have already learned about it, isn't it? Okay, evaporating seawater. And one of the other salts we use commonly are alum and baking soda. Okay, other salt we commonly used are alum and baking soda. Okay, alum is used to clean water. Alum is used for cleaning water. Okay, and baking soda is used just as it is in the kitchen as part of cooking. Okay, and as baking powder. Okay, then when a pinch of baking powder put in hot water, you can see it is fizzing out some gases. You can see that a gas start fizzing out. Okay, this gas is carbon dioxide. And this is what makes the cake rise and become spongy when a mixer of flour, baking powder and other things placed in an oven. Okay, like that only we make cake. The flour, baking powder and other things mix and keep it in an oven. That cake becomes spongy because the baking powder, when it is react to hot, okay, when it is in the hot oven, it produce carbon dioxide and become the cake become spongy. Okay, and these are the common salt we use. Okay, so this is about the portion. By this we complete this lesson. Okay, let's revise what we have learned today. First thing, what are the substances formed when acid and a base combine? When acid and a base combine, the substances formed are salt and water. Name three salt we use. the common salt we use in the kitchen to add flavor. Then alum and baking soda, these are three salt we commonly use. Okay, and what is the use of alum? Alum is used for cleaning water. Alum is used to clean water. And baking soda, baking soda is used just as it is in the kitchen as a part of baking powder. Okay, these are the commonly used salt. And what gas is formed when the baking powder is put in the hot water? That is, the gas formed is carbon dioxide. The gas formed is carbon dioxide. And that's all for the for today's portion. And you have to read the lesson many times. And tomorrow we'll discuss with the exercise part of this lesson. Okay, exercise part. And really, you have to read at least thrice in a day this portion. Okay, lesson. Thank you.